We live in sunny California where the weather is amazing, but we do need to take the sun seriously. More than 9,500 people are diagnosed with some form of skin cancer every day. One of those people dies from melanoma every hour. So much of it is contributed to UV, the sun, and the rays. Today, we are telling skin cancer to take a hike. With me now, Dr. Shane Hamman from West Dermatology. Hello. And Veronica, who has a very personal experience with skin cancer. So today, we want to raise awareness, and we're talking about the Take a Hike event, which is happening this Saturday. All right, Dr. Shane, Veronica, welcome.
Thank you. First of all,
I know we're talking about a new sort of non-invasive skin biopsy that we're doing to test for skin cancer, correct?
Yes. So this is a new technology. This is great. What it does is it uses an adhesive sticker to test the RNA in lesions and send it off without having to remove any of the skin.
Now, how is this different from what we did before? Before you would kind of scrape, or what would you do?
So we would anesthetize the area and take a small sample and send it off to a lab to look under pathology.
Okay.
What this does is it risk stratifies lesions and says, hey, is this a risky mole or is this a safe one?
Oh, I see.
So it doesn't completely eliminate the need for a biopsy, but it can help us, say, eliminate some biopsies that we might have done, and it can also help us maybe do one that we wouldn't have. So my partner at the office, Dr. Bruja, had a young girl and didn't want to do the biopsy. But he did this test. It came back positive.
Okay.
We found a melanoma. We got it out. She's healthy and
safe.
There
you go. And how quickly can you find out if this is something you need to get tested?
So you go in to see your dermatologist, and if they have this, they can just sample it right then and there. So any mole that might be suspicious or might be concerning, they can take a sample and just sort of say, hey, is this a risky one or is it a safe one?
Right.
And gives you some peace of mind or says, hey, we need to do some more testing.
Now, Veronica, what is your story?
So I have a long line of family that has skin cancer, and so I've always had to take extra precautionary steps and make sure that I get yearly exams, skin cancer screenings, and seeing my favorite dermatologist, West Dermatology. And we're having an event this Saturday to raise awareness for skin cancer and prevention, just to let everyone know that there's options out there and to raise awareness and make sure people know that they have options.
And it's scary. So I moved from Chicago, and I'm going to be really honest. I put sunblock on every 5 minutes. I came from a background where in high school and college, I tanned and I over-tanned.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And now that I'm older, you wisen up and you say to yourself, not so safe. So you have to put the sunblock on. Tell me about these products that you have. What should we be doing on a daily basis to protect ourselves from the sun and from cancer?
So you're doing the right thing. So first of all, you're using sunscreen.
Yeah.
And people ask me which sunscreen to use. The most important sunscreen is the one that you're going to use. These are all great products. I love this one, Elta MD, SPF 45. Put this on a regular basis. You're supposed to put it on before you go outside and reapply every 2 hours.
But so here's what I'll tell you. I actually use this brand, I'm not kidding, and I use the SPF 45. But for example, I went to Costa Rica last summer and I felt like I needed a higher SPF, even though I was constantly putting it on. So, but you're saying it's okay to go for the higher SPF, right?
It's definitely okay. The fact is most of us don't put enough on or often enough.
Okay.
So a little extra number is great.
So that's a good question. How much do we put on? Is it a quarter size? We just, you know, cover our face in it?
One fingertip of sunscreen is good for your face.
Oh.
It's good for two hands.
Well, now I'm using way too much.
So
it's expensive.
Yeah, so you got to put, so one fingertip will cover two hands worth.
Okay.
So that's your face.
All right.
So you just make sure you're getting lots around. There's lots of other great products out there. I love this brand because it's a high SPF and it goes on and you can't see it on your face.
Okay.
HelioCare is a really neat product. This is a vitamin that kind of helps your skin be a little bit resistant. It is not to replace sunscreen, but it's something you can use in addition.
And this is something you ingest.
This is a vitamin.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a wonderful vitamin.
I'll be taking those.
Yeah.
Of course, we gotta wear hats, right?
Yeah.
Sunglasses.
So
these are great.
The things you do is.
What is that?
It's a hat. Poppable hat.
There you go. Do you think people will laugh at me? At least I'm not going to get, you know, skin cancer.
And you look younger, right?
Exactly. People ask me all the time. They see I'm in San Diego. They say, where's your tan? I say, nuh-uh. No tan for me unless it's from the bottle.
That's right.
So just a lot of these products. And where can people go to get more information for this weekend's event? Take a Hike. Warning people against skin cancer.
So there's a website for fundraising, but you can actually just go to our Facebook page. It's facebook.com/West Dermatology, and we have all the information. It links to the page that has more information about the hike and where you can also donate.
There's no sun right now, but that doesn't mean you don't need sunscreen.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for sharing your
story. Thank you so much.
Come out for this weekend's event, Take a Hike. Heather and Eric. Heather and Eric. I combined your names.
We're like a celebrity duo now.
We're okay with you telling us to take a hike, especially when it comes
comes to that.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, Jenny, I was the same as you. I made so many mistakes in my younger years. I just want to reverse time and go back and
can't do it.
Add a lot more sunscreen.
Tell those teenagers, don't tan. Don't do it.
Not do it. It'll never be worth it. Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Jenny. The generosity of